Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to begin our graduation ceremony, and I'd like to take this moment to welcome you to our first virtual graduation. The flags on the stage represent the diverse nationalities of the students we honor today.
On behalf of the graduation committee, I will now invite the International School of Ulaanbaatar's administrative team and board chair to stand to be introduced. Mr. Bill Elman, the director of the International School of Ulaanbaatar. Mr. Gary Briando, chair of the board of trustees of the International School of Ulaanbaatar. And Ms. Tol Araldi, the deputy director of ISU. And Ms. Cynthia Wisman, ISU's head of secondary. And Mr. Colin Powell, ISU's head of primary. And I'm Ms. Irtens de Beindorch, and this is Mr. David Panford. We are the advisors for this year's graduating class and your MCs for this ceremony.
And now we welcome ISU's graduating class of 2021.
Thank you, all of you, for joining us today for the International School of Ulaanbaatar's 2021 graduation ceremony. And now I would like to invite Mr. Bill Elman, the director of the International School of Ulaanbaatar, to open our ceremony.
Thanks, Ms. Eggie. Good morning and hello to our students, faculty, staff, parents, ISU alumni, members of our Board of Trustees, and other distinguished virtual attendees. I'm honored to welcome you to ISU's 18th graduation ceremony, celebrating the accomplishments of the class of 2021. For a second year, we have lived separated, but undivided. This year's graduating class has endured more or less a full 2 years of IB diploma study online. Their dedication to their studies and their completion of the program is a testimony to their determination, their maturity, and their mutual support. What follows are some brief reflections on the graduating class's chosen theme of flexibility. This is not about a gymnastics of the body, but is instead about gymnastics of the temperament and the intellect. To the class of 2021, the pandemic has altered or erased a lot of opportunities and desirable outcomes which you might otherwise have wished for. And I'm sure that there was some anger and mourning of those losses. You might have shaken your fists and looked for someone to blame. You might even have taken your anger out on people who brought you the message of those lost opportunities. But I know that in the midst of your anger, you have also acquired a wisdom that is hard-won and life-changing. And that is a wisdom which knows when and how to be flexible. This newfound adaptability will make you more effective decision makers and more effective moral agents by giving you a clearer sense of your priorities for the rest of your lives. The anger that many of you will have felt this past year relates to notions of equity, how unfair the current situation is, in so many ways. And it's not always bad to feel anger. A certain moral indignation is a precondition for fighting injustice. As your values have developed and been refined, they've been tempered in the fires of adversity. It's an adversity over which we have little control, either jointly or severally. A critical life lesson that has emerged from the inevitability of our current circumstance is how and in which ways we should live with it. We need to know how to adapt and to what extent to adapt. COVID does not permit everything to continue as before, but nor does that license the abandonment of everything we've done before. Some things should change, and some things need not. But where to rage? Your newfound wisdom comes in your ability to weigh that very thing. My father is a wellspring of wise observations. Actions speak louder than words, Bill. You catch more flies with honey. Bill, don't eat that meatball off the ground. But one such observation has risen above the others as a mantra. When you're dead right, you're still dead. Also phrasable as choose your battles. Injustice should not be tolerated, and for the rest of your lives, I hope that you will stay true to your values and keep alive the sense of righteous indignation which prompts you to fight inequity wherever you find it. But life will often present you with many injustices, often at once, and so your anger must be tempered by your flexibility, as shown by your ability to prioritize. Having the presence of mind to hold your indignation in abeyance, to read a situation and weigh the prescriptions of your conscience, this is a gift which the last 18 months under COVID lockdowns should have honed in you. The latter-day philosopher Mitch Hedberg observed, "The depressing thing about tennis is that no matter how good you get, you'll never be as good as a wall. A wall is relentless." The events of the past 18 months will have taught us all that we cannot defeat a wall. But one critical gift of your education and your COVID experience is that you can evaluate whether the obstacle you face is a wall at all. You know walls. You've become wall experts. And in this capacity, you know when a wall will give way to the force of your will and when it will not. It's not that you should never push against a real wall. Being dead right is not the worst place to be, and it's not to be avoided at all costs. It's just that you can only be dead once. That means you have limited pennies to spend in your life on the battles you will wage. And that realization should heighten your sense of the importance of priorities and your understanding of what matters and where and when you must act for the rest of your lives. So here's a summary of the gifts of your recent experience, your newfound flexibility. You're prepared for a life fought and lived in consonance with your values. You know a wall when you see one. You can evaluate its strength and the cost of your efforts to level it. You can hold that cost against your growingly clear list of priorities to decide whether or not to act. And you can rage against those walls whose separations cannot and must not be endured. To the class of 2021, may your lives and your learning tear down walls, real and perceived, wherever you go. Congratulations to all of you.
Thank you, Mr. Ellman. And now on behalf of the administration, Ms. Cynthia Wisman.
...and faculty to this unique graduation day at the International School of Ulaanbaatar. The young women and men on the screen before us, never thought I'd say that, had accomplished a significant milestone in their lives. We come together today to honor them, to recognize their achievements, to celebrate their journey thus far, and to remind them once again about how much we believe in them. Today marks the end of an incredible era, one that we will never forget. And while we pause to reflect on all that has brought us to this moment, we also look ahead with confidence, hoping to position them well in the next part of that journey. At ISU, you've had the opportunity to learn and to grow, to fail, to try again, and to consistently strive to learn more, be more, and know more. Like every year, we started the 2020-21 school year with the hopes and dreams of coming together, connecting our hearts and minds to build a legacy, your legacy. And yet, we have had another unusual year as the pandemic has challenged the way we do school and has challenged the way we think about connections. This unique global experience will have shaped us in many ways, which will have an impact on how we connect, reflect, and learn for years to come. When I think back, what I love about school is the cyclical nature of it. It has a predictable beginning, middle, and end, only to restart when the new school year begins. Each year, we count on that predictability. That includes sporting events, fundraisers, university fairs, week without walls, productions, celebrations, and more, all of which you've been a part of and have contributed to. We count on that predictability to help us navigate through life. It creates patterns and organization that allows us to make plans. And yet, what these last couple of years have taught us is that there are no certainties. For every plan and event in our calendars, we've had to adapt, change, and be flexible. Your paths were all but linear or predictable. You adapted to the online life, the never-ending cycle of each day feeling much like the last. Yet somehow, you've all made new discoveries, new connections, and gained new experiences. When you look back over the year, what discoveries, connections, and experiences have you made? What did you learn about yourself? All of you have had exceptional experiences and moments through this school year and created your own stories with a beginning, middle, and end. You were able to overcome some difficult situations by remaining flexible, diligent, and supportive. Take time to reflect on this experience. It's time to write your next story and think about how you might start fresh wherever you may be. What skills or advice can you take with you into the next year, and what habits would you like to leave behind? You have an opportunity to begin again. As you reflect, you will see all the hard work, perseverance, and flexibility that went into attaining your goals and your individual successes. We will celebrate some of your accomplishments today, but there's so much more to all of you than what can be shown here. You are 18 unique individuals, all with your own unique academic and social talents. I have borrowed a quote from Steve Jobs that I really feel summarizes your hopes and dreams for you. In his commencement speech at Stanford University, he said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living somebody else's life. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your own heart and intuition." I hope your years at ISU, with the help of outstanding teachers and staff, have given you just that, the courage to follow your heart and mind. After having spent the last 3 years with you, I feel confident that your future has never looked as bright. You are curious, you are kind, you are flexible and incredibly brave, and you are ready to take on the world and all that it has to offer. I would like to close with a story I read on social media. The original story is titled, "Why Dogs Live Less Than Humans, According to a Six-Year-Old." The story is just what the title suggests, where a six-year-old explains that people are born so that they can learn how to live a good life, like loving everybody all the time and being nice. He continued, "Well, dogs already know how to do that, so they don't have to stay for as long as we do." So where am I going with this, you might wonder? The story ends with life lessons or truths, perhaps, that we learn from pets that I think apply to our graduates. And I will call these the secrets of happiness that you learned living under COVID. Live simply, love generously, care deeply, speak kindly. Remember the things you've learned from this experience and take them with you. When your loved one comes home, always run to greet them. Allow the experience of fresh air and wind in your face to be pure ecstasy. Take naps. Stretch before rising. Play daily. On warm days, stop to lie on your back on the grass. When you're happy, dance around and wiggle your entire body. Delight in the simple joy of a long walk. Never pretend to be something you're not. If what you want lies buried, dig until you find it. And these actions, graduates, are the secrets to happiness. Be happy, class of 2021. And as Bob Marley said, don't worry about a thing, because every little thing gonna be all right. Good luck, and thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Wiseman. Next, I would like to introduce Lina Ichioka, who will represent the class to introduce our teacher speaker.
Good morning, parents, teachers, and fellow graduates. Mr. Panford has worked at ISU for 4 years now as a physics teacher, is a notable musician, and one of the technical experts at multiple school events, working with many students of different year groups. He has been our advisory teacher alongside Ms. Eggy for the past 2 years through our IB diploma journey. Not only did he watch us grow and become the unique individuals we are today, we were also there to watch his journey of becoming a father. And although he sometimes would laugh at how stressed we were, he would always put in the effort to check in with each of us, which we all greatly appreciated. With that said, please help me extend a warm welcome to our selected teacher speaker, Mr. David Panford.
The chair of ISU's Board of Trustees, school administration, parents, faculty, students in the class of 2021. While I'm greatly honored to be selected as the teacher speaker for this august occasion, I couldn't help but wonder why. Why me? And even as I sat there nervously waiting for my turn, I still had the exact same question. Why me? Thing is, in 2017, I embarked on a full research project into Mongolia. This was, of course, because I'd picked a job in a country I knew nothing about. But my first trip to the countryside was in September of that same year, Ideals Week. And then I found something that my research failed to reveal. Here we were, faced with having to ride horses, and a little boy just about half my height jumps on the horse and is riding like a professional. And here I was, over 6 feet tall, and very scared. And I was scared not only because, you know, I'm so tall and yet so scared, but also because such a strong animal and it is obeying and submitting to a very little boy. I couldn't help but wonder why. Why would this animal give in to that boy? Having known most of the members of the class of 2021 casually since joining ISU, it was not until January of 2019 that I had the privilege of teaching them. Again, I was very nervous going into that first class because I'd heard so many good things about that class that I felt the need to match their energy. Needless to say, I was not disappointed at all. Now, the class of 2021 is not only known for being very good academically, but also being very balanced. So it was no surprise that every year they won the lip sync battle competitions that were held. Now, as fate would have it, I became one of their homeroom advisors later that year. This, I would say, was the beginning of a real meaningful working relationship. I continued to look forward to each meeting, whether it was them venting about the stress of the diploma program or yelling because somebody breathed too hard during a domino challenge and all the tiles came falling down, or even while we were playing charades. Every meeting was one to look forward to. During the last 2 years, I've been privileged to watch closely as these young adults have successfully navigated and overcome the challenges of the rigorous IB diploma program. They did so in spite of the uncertainties and chaos that accompanies a global pandemic. It is no secret that online learning is very challenging, to say the least. I remember our first advisory meeting during the meeting lockdown. At the beginning of the meeting, I was the only one that had my camera on. This was awkward. But a few minutes into it, and Annie and Lena simultaneously turned on their camera, And one by one, every one of them turned their cameras on too. Now, this is just one of the many examples that show how the class of 2021 was flexible, they were one, and they had empathy for all at all times. Our senior trip is a memory I'm sure that all of them hold very dear. The opportunity to bond and to create lifelong memories and de-stress from the pressures of academic work was fully optimized. Now, not even the physics test the Monday afterwards was enough to stop these students from having fun. The smiles, the pictures, the tears, and the memories from that weekend would forever be cherished. We celebrate the class of 2021 today because even though they faced and endured some of the most challenging conditions under which anyone can earn a diploma, they continue to excel through it all. You stayed true to yourselves and persevered. As I thought about this speech and why me, I was reminded of that little boy. That boy chose not to focus on how little he was compared to the horse or all the things that could possibly go wrong while on it. He grew up probably knowing and believing that a horse is meant to follow its master, and that's all he cared about. And so that day in 2017, I also got on a horse because I said to myself, if that boy can, then so can I. Sometimes life puts you against some very enormous opponents, like being called as a teacher speaker. Some of the tasks and opportunities of life appear so daunting, we're almost certain that we do not measure up. But most times these limitations exist only in our heads. And so as I got on that horse and my fear and disbelief in my abilities began to diminish, I realized that I could actually do this. And just like that little boy, I shouted the famous "Choo!" and the horse began to move. And now I remember that day fondly as my day one for horse riding. Class of 2021, always remember that each day of your life could be day one or one day. You decide. And so to Ischams the listener, Nomu the leader, the creative Oyumbat, the assertive Cosmo, the talented Inkchin, the friendly Cassandra, to Rose the thinker, to the caring Lena, to the kind Sayako, Suwan the hard worker, pitch perfect in Seo, meticulous Zara, to the selfless Annie, confident Dogen, courageous Angelo, Hiso the determined, the polite Hazel, and the thoughtful Inksol. Always remember the words of Ralph Waldo Emerson. What lies behind you and what lies before you are small matters compared to what lies within you. I know I speak for all teachers when I say that we're extremely proud of you and all that you have accomplished. We have full confidence in your abilities to make an impact everywhere you find yourself and to fulfill your dreams. So when times get tough, when you feel like giving up, when you think that you aren't good enough, when you wonder whether or not you can make it, and maybe like Mr. Panford, all you can ask is why me? Remember that little boy and his horse. Smile and say to yourself, if they can do it, then so can you. True! If not you, then who? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Panford. And now I would like to introduce to you our guest commencement speaker, Mr. Alex Hykens. Alex Hykens is the representative of the United Nations Children's Fund Mongolia. He joined UNICEF in 2013 as a senior advisor at UNICEF headquarters, New York, leading the development and implementation of UNICEF's policy on climate change, energy, and environmental sustainability. Prior to UNICEF, Mr. Hykens held various roles in the United Nations Development Program in Asia Pacific, developing, supporting, and implementing UNDP's climate change portfolio. He previously worked for the Food and Agriculture Organization and has earned both PhD and Master's in Science. Please help me to extend a warm welcome to our esteemed guest speaker, Mr. Hykens.
Congratulations, everybody. I really wish that all of you, for the rest of your lives, will be like bamboo. And you must be wondering, why bamboo? Bamboo is a very interesting material. It is known for flexibility and for integrity. Flexibility, it goes with the wind. Integrity, it is very strong and can withstand a lot of pressure. For you, flexibility means adaptability to any new situation. And integrity means the quality of being honest and having strong moral principles. Looking back over the last few years at ISU, you guys had a really tough time. Especially because of the pandemic, it was difficult these 2 years. For example, I think about 70% of your time you had to work from home. Online classes, online meetings, online testing, no sports events or any other events, no socializing with your friends, quarantine and isolation, anxiety and stress, what you guys had to deal with. So in a way, you were already pressurized a lot in terms of your flexibility and your integrity. Moving forward, it will be even more important, your flexibility and integrity. And it starts within the next couple of months, where many of you will start moving to a new country, start a new study, and start to live on your own for the first time. It reminds me of my own first time when I moved abroad from the Netherlands to Indonesia. I just graduated from university and I saw an advertisement for a PhD research project. And it was really exciting, but there was one requirement, and that was to be based in Indonesia for at least 1 year. And I had never been outside of Europe. I had never thought about working abroad, and I just got a girlfriend. So I was basically afraid to jump into that. I was not sure if I would be flexible, adaptable enough to deal with such a new environment. Well, my girlfriend, she gave me a little push, and she told me that I was absolutely crazy if I would not apply for the job. If I would not even try it, she would probably break up with me. So I did, of course, apply for the job. I did get the job. And in Indonesia, I really learned what is flexibility. And I also learned how to be flexible. And I really started to enjoy life in this very new environment. So a few years later, when I was at the end of my PhD work, I saw another job advertisement. A job with the United Nations in Bangladesh. This time I did not hesitate. I jumped right into it. In case you wonder what happened to that girlfriend, this year we are celebrating our 20th wedding anniversary. In life, you will find many situations where you will be challenged in terms of your integrity and your flexibility. And the question is going to be, how are you going to deal with that? Let me give you some examples from my own experiences. At some point in my career, I was hired as a water quality expert. And on the second day of my job, my supervisor came to me and he asked, "Alex, what do you know about climate change?" I said, "Well, I've heard about it." He said, "Great, forget about water quality. From now on, you will be working on climate change. Is that okay?" I thought about it for a second, and I said, "Sure, why not? Let's give it a try." I studied hard, I worked hard, and a few years later, we had a big climate change program in that office. In another job, I was really challenged on my integrity. From the day I started working in that office, I realized there were a lot of things in that office that were wrong. And then also my boss started to ask me to do things that I really disagreed with. And I said, "No, I am not going to do it." No surprise, it ended up in a big fight, but it was a fight worth having. And I did not give up my integrity. I did find a new job and I moved on. Over the years, what I've learned in my career, It is very important to keep that integrity and flexibility. And there will be these tensions as well sometimes between flexibility and integrity. If you become too flexible, especially with regard to your integrity, you run the risk of damaging that integrity. And even bamboo can break. And when your integrity is damaged, people will lose trust, and it will be very hard to rebuild that trust. On the other hand, if you maintain your flexibility and your integrity, any difficult situation you can handle. And any good opportunity that comes along, you can grab it. And that's why I think all of you should be like bamboo for the rest of your lives, and I wish you a great future.
Thank you very much, Mr. Biondo, Mr. Hyken, sorry, for that speech. I'd like to call upon two members of the graduating class who volunteered for their class to speak on their behalf. It is my pleasure to introduce Annie Newby and Ishams Bhatt Ocher.
Good afternoon, friends, faculty, and guests. Flexibility is a word that can encompass what many of our journeys in school has been like. In primary school, flexibility was sitting with a different group of friends at lunch. It was deciding who we would share our toys with. And while at the time, flexibility seemed unbearably hard, little did we know what it would come to mean to us today. I speak for all of us when I say change hasn't always come easy. We've seen our closest friends and favorite teachers leave. Many of us have moved around the world and had to adapt to new environments. And of course, we cannot talk about flexibility without mentioning online learning. Despite the time apart, our class has consistently managed to stay connected to one another. Each and every one of us sitting here today has formed lifelong friendships and a group who, through it all, has shared laughs and made memories. We've each shared new experiences together, visiting deserts, getting lost in forests, and traveling through rivers on canoes. At times, experiencing new things may have seemed daunting, but all of us have welcomed adversity and overcame our challenges. Our class consists of some of ISU's strongest athletes, artists, musicians, debaters, and numerous other talents. Through all our hobbies, we also had to balance the challenges that came with completing the IB, reaching deadlines, completing assignments, and for a large chunk of time, having to do so from our bedrooms. It was never easy, but we conquered our challenges and moved on to the next hurdle. Our class has seen it all. We've seen all the changes our school has gone through, and alongside all the changes we've experienced in our personal lives. Having been a part of this class for over 11 years now, I've witnessed how change has hurt each of us, but also how it continues to strengthen us to better adapt to the unknown. As we move on to this next phase in our lives, we will continue to discover flexibility in different ways. Sitting here alongside me could be future politicians, engineers, entrepreneurs, and artists. Regardless of our plans, whether we are the next Jeff Bezos or we are still living with our parents, one thing that will remain constant is the willingness and preparedness we all have for the changes that face our future. Thank you.
Family, friends, faculty, and fellow graduates, and thank you for attending. Today we have all been assembled to celebrate the accomplishment of our high school graduation. This is a major milestone for all of us and one that should be recognized for its immense significance, as it not only marks the ending of our high school career, but also the beginning of our lives as adults. It is only after graduation that we can freely explore all of our ideas and pursue the many achievements of our dreams. Our high school career has seen lots of hardships, but through these challenges, we have had the opportunity to learn and grow as individuals. True growth can only be achieved by adapting to difficult situations and thriving under them. We cannot become what we want by remaining who we are. So in order to successfully attain our dreams, we have to be flexible to new situations. The class of 2021 has been an excellent example of achieving growth through flexibility, especially this year where the student population had to endure online learning. Adapting to this change has not been easy, to say the least. We have all undergone phases of low motivation. However, the mentality that I didn't come this far to only come this far was what allowed us to push ourselves to become the best versions of who we are. Another recent example of our class overcoming adversity and demonstrating adaptability was when a lot of us had to balance our school lives with extracurricular activities, particularly students who were active in sports, debates, out-of-school activities, and all of them at once, possibly. I particularly remember days where after school practice finished, we had to immediately go home to work on our IAs despite our tired conditions. We have also shown great reaction to last-minute changes, as whether we were taking the IB exams or not was not decided until a very late point. To prepare for this, all of us had to continue studying with the assumption that they would occur, showing our ability to prepare for uncertain possibilities. Completing high school is not the end goal. It is instead a part of the larger journey of life. Let this be living proof that when you have set your mind towards something, truly anything is possible. Hence, I can see the future success of all my peers, as we have all displayed the ability to learn from our mistakes, adapt, and improve ourselves.
Thank you, Annie and Ishjant. And now I have the pleasure of introducing the presenters of the ISU Graduate Awards. Today, we celebrate the academic success of our graduates. This celebration is also an opportunity to publicly honor three very special achievements. In recognition of these achievements, we will now present the ISU Graduate Awards. The first award, the Award for Community Service, will be presented by ISU's Deputy Director, Ms. Tol Eraldi.
Thank you, Ms. Egi. I'm honored to present this award for community service to Sayaka Inoue. Sayaka has shown sincere enthusiasm for CAS throughout the duration of her DP journey. She created two CAS projects, 12 CAS experiences, and presented 68 genuine reflections and collections of evidence, despite the challenging circumstances we all faced during the pandemic. Sayaka's projects and experiences clearly demonstrated a willingness to go beyond her comfort zone and encompassed a wide range of experiences, from tutoring peers, learning a new musical instrument, volunteering to read a book, and participating in writing contest and participating in Whitting Peak Challenge. We congratulate Sayaka Inoue's extraordinary accomplishments and are pleased to give her the 2021 Award for Community Service.
Thank you, Ms. Ariodi and Sayako Inoue. Our second award, the Director's Distinction Award, will be presented by the ISU Director, Mr. Bill Ellman.
On behalf of our faculty, staff, and administration, it gives me great pride to present this award to Zara Mansour. In granting this award, we celebrate Zara's strong intellectual abilities, her passion, and her diligence in the pursuit of excellence. In addition to having the highest predicted grade in her class, Zara epitomizes balance and well-roundedness in her learning, which this award recognizes and celebrates. As a knowledgeable thinker, she communicates with empathy and an open mind. She always cares for and supports her classmates. Throughout her successful completion of CAS, TOK, and the extended essay, Zara demonstrated exceptional attention to details and was meticulous in her approach to learning and problem solving. In or out of the classroom, online or in person, Zara continually models what a principled and excellent student should be. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you this year's recipient of the 2021 Director's Distinction Award, Zara Mansour.
Thank you, Mr. Elman and Zara. And our final award, ISU's Board of Trustees Award for Leadership, will be presented by Mr. Gary Biondo, Chair of the ISU Board of Trustees.
Thank you, Ms. Egge. On behalf of the ISU Board of Trustees, I am very happy to present the Award for Leadership to Nomundara Bulbatar. In her time at ISU, Nomundara has demonstrated leadership in all aspects of ISU life, in athletics, in performing arts, in visual arts, and also in the classroom. She has pursued personal growth. She has learned from her mistakes, she has reflected, and got back up after defeat. Her ability to accept full responsibility for her actions and to protect and guide the younger students and to take leadership when needed have been remarkable. On international trips with the athletic teams, she practically functioned as an extra staff member. She possesses key leadership qualities, has earned the trust of her teachers and coaches, and the respect of her teammates and classmates. Nomundara Bulbatar reminds us that leadership often means prioritizing team goals over individual desires, so we enthusiastically present her with the 2021 ISU Board of Trustees Leadership Award.
Thank you, Mr. Biondo and Nomundara. And now Mr. Bill Elman will present the graduates to ISU's Board of Trustees.
Thank you, Mr. Panford. And I would also like to ask that Mr. Gary Biondo, Chairman of the Board of Trustees, join me, please. Mr. Biondo, as the Director of ISU, and on behalf of our faculty and our administration, I vouch that the students before us have successfully completed all of their academic requirements from our programs of study, including the Theory of Knowledge course, their CAS, and their extended essays. And so I introduce to you the International School of Ulaanbaatar's future class of 2021.
Thank you, Mr. Elman. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I wish to congratulate the future graduates of 2021. I am honored to be here with them this afternoon, and I invite you and Ms. Egge and Mr. Panford to call these students to be recognized and receive their diplomas.
Thank you, Mr. Biondo. I'd also like to ask or to invite Ms. Cynthia Wisman, Ms. Tula Arildi, and Mr. Colin Powell to join us in the presentations.
Ishjams would like to express his appreciation to the ISU faculty for continuing to work hard to help the students. Ishjams. Nomundara would like to thank her fellow classmates for their friendship and resilience, and she would like to thank her teachers and the ISU faculty for their stewardship, support, and compassion. It was a great honor to learn under your guidance and to be part of such a grand community. Nomundara. Oyumbat wants to thank everybody who believed in who she was and who she is becoming. Her future goal is to help others who struggle to find their own voice and identity. Oyumbat.
Cosmo Nuri Dipmar.
Cosmo would like to thank all of his friends for making his time at ISU the best it could possibly be and is looking forward to continuing the friendships for the rest of his life. Cosmo. Ingjin would like to thank Ms. Moyasa and the art class. Inkjin.
Erdin's Sukhin, Cassandra.
Cassandra's goal is to become an interior designer and grow as an artist. Cassandra.
Rose Wendelin Hikens.
Rose would like to thank certain teachers for supporting her during the DP years. Rose.
Lina Ichioka.
Lina would like to thank her family and friends for their love and support throughout these last 2 years. Lina.
Sayako Inoue.
Sayako would like to warmly thank everyone who has supported her. Sayako.
Suwon Jan.
Suwon's goal is to achieve success in whatever country he ends up living in. Suwon.
Yanseo Lee.
Yanseo would like to look back at her years spent at ISU and acknowledge everyone she has met during this time. Yanseo.
Zara Shaheen Mansour.
Zara would like to thank her teachers and friends who helped her through the last 2 difficult years. Zara.
Annie Michelle Newby.
Annie would like to thank all her friends and family for supporting her through the hardships. Annie.
Norjun Bhatin Dulgun.
Dulgun would like to thank his peers and teachers for their endless support. Dulgun.
Angelo Delphine Paradis Carascal.
Angelo would like to thank his teachers and friends that helped him through the process. Angelo. Hisa would like to thank her family and friends for encouraging her to do her best even when times were tough. Hisa.
Hazel Monet Tepper.
Hazel would like to thank all her teachers for their support and everything they helped her do during online school. Hazel. Ingsul would like to thank her friends and the ISU teachers for educating and supporting her throughout her DP journey. Ingsul.
It is now time for all of you to graduate. Please grab your tassels. Now please move them to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce you to ISU's graduating class of 2021. Now, before we end this afternoon's ceremony, I would like to thank Mr. Alex Hikens for honoring our celebrations today with his thoughts. I'd also like to thank Mr. Biondo for presiding with us and our grade 12 advisors for being our hosts. I'm additionally grateful for all of the work of the ISU graduation committee. And there's more. And the hours and expertise of our technical team who've become an integral part of productions that are in a largely virtual ceremony. And finally, I'd like to thank all of our parents, our teachers, and any other viewers who joined us to celebrate the achievements of our graduates. As we close these proceedings, I would like to invite Angelo Paradis to stand and offer a farewell to the class of 2021. Angelo?
Good morning, esteemed faculties and families of my fellow graduates. It's an honor to be standing up here today. I know we all think we're immortal. We're supposed to feel that way. We're graduating. The future is and should be bright. But like our brief years in high school, what makes life viable is that it doesn't last forever. What makes us precious is that it ends. I know that more now than ever. And I said today of all this to remind us that time is luck. So don't waste it living someone else's life. Make yours count for something. Fight for what matters to you, no matter what. Because even if you fall short, what better way there is to live? It's easy to feel hopeful on a beautiful day like today. But there will be dark days ahead of us too. And there will be days where you will feel all alone. And that's when hope is needed the most. No matter how bad it gets or how lost you feel, you must promise me, your classmate, your friend, and your brother, that you will hold on to the hope and keep it alive. We have to be greater than we suffer. My wish for you is to become hope. People need that. I know it feels like we're saying goodbye, but we will carry a piece of each other into everything we're gonna do next to remind us of who we are and what we're meant to be. I've had a great 2 years with all of you, and I will miss you a lot. And yourself.
One, two, three.
Congratulations.
Thank you, class of 2021. As these proceedings close, we will honor our graduates with a video created by the class.
What you need to do is be thankful for the life you got, you know what I'm saying? Stop looking at what you ain't got. Start being thankful for what you do got. Let's get it to him, baby girl. Hey.
Hey. That's right.
Rihanna, let's get it.
Catch a case and watch my future fade away. And the swagger of a college kid, ignoring all prior advice and forewarning, and we might it full of ourselves all of a sudden, aren't we?
I can tell that we are gonna be friends.